two epic names colliding in the magical world where Dumbledore is trying to stop dark and evil plans of Grindelwald. Who's going to win? And most importantly, is this fight worth watching? Let's find out.
Magic blooms.
Legacy of Harry Potter will never end, period. J.K. Rowling can't let go this magical extravaganza that she created over thousands of pages. The magical world of Harry has mesmerized generations of kids who feel enchanted while reading the fascinating tale of this wizard and his wizardry. Fans of Harry Potter were tripping when J.K. hit the silver screen with Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them as a prequel. That movie was brilliant, that reignited the charm of old magical world. Sadly, the second installation of this prequel saga is nothing but a long prologue with too many plot twists. Movie starts within few months of Grindelwald getting arrested in the end of the first movie. As expected, he's escaped and on his path of mega destruction that will target all muggles. Will Grindelwald be able to succeed? How will Dumbledore and his student Newt going to stop him? Who will die and who will escape? Is Credence finally going to meet his parents? This movie is the answer to all these questions.
It has to be you.
In your shoes, I'd probably refuse to. It's late.
Good evening, Newt.
Oh, come on.
Really like Johnny Depp. Time and time again, he proved himself to be one of the finest actors in Hollywood. And he did not disappoint this time as well. So do Jude Law as Dumbledore. Both of them are the real plus point of this movie. Their screen presence, especially Johnny Depp, with his haunting looks and voice will leave you in splits. Eddie Redmayne as Newt, Katherine Waterston as Tina, Alison Sudol as Queenie, one of my favorites, Dan Fogler as Jacob Kowalski, Ezra Miller as Credence, Zoe Kravitz as Leeta, and Callum Turner as Theseus, brother of Newt, are good in their roles and able to excite fans. They are apt. Surprisingly, you won't see much of the Beast this time. And that is just sad. I mean, the name of the movie says Fantastic Beasts. And that's where you disappoint us. You will see some monsters. You will see some beautiful beasts. I wanted to see more of these monsters, man. It's like reading a novel and getting lost while reading to know the end of it, which is actually laying foundation for the next novel. Multiple subplots and different timelines have made it little difficult and leave us slightly frustrated. Feels like they forgot the beauty of simplicity that was there in the first movie. However, I was surprised with the ending where they reveal something that will challenge all the fans to rethink everything they know about Dumbledore. That's it. I'm not saying anything. I'm going out with 7 out of 10 for Fantastic Beasts, Crimes of Grindelwald. Just a suggestion, watch it on IMAX only, as the experience is too good to be real. This is Mad Over Movies. I'll see you very soon. Till then, please do like or subscribe. Bye-bye.